In this video, we are going to understand the concept of pipes in Angular. Angular 1.0 versions has a filters which are used for many common uses like formatting dates and if you want to convert your string in upper or lower cases. These filters are known as pipes in Angular 4. Pipes basically allows you to change the data inside the template. Normally, a pipe is going to take the data and transform this input into the desired output. There are many built-in pipes in Angular 4. We are going to have a look on them. So for this demonstration of pipes, I have created a new project named as pipes. Now within this, I'm going to make a use of source, and within this source, I'm going to make a use of app.component.html file. So now within this app.component.html file, I'm going to remove all this content, and within this, I'm going to make a use of pipes. In order to work with a pipe, I'm going to make a use of this app.component.ts file, and within this export class app component, I'm going to declare a variable named as name. And here I'm going to specify a string within this name, and I'm going to write pipes. So here I have created a variable named as name, and I have initialized a value of pipe to this variable name. Now within this app.component.html, I'm going to display this name. For this, I'm going to make a use of h2 tag, and within this string interpolation, I'm going to specify my variable name. So now I'm going to save all this application and test this program. So as you can see that this webpack has been compiled successfully, and if I run this program, you can see that a pipe has been returned out. Now, if I want to convert this name pipes into an uppercase or in a lowercase, I can make a use of Angular pipes. So what exactly we need to do is, here in my app.component.html file, I'm going to make a use of pipe. This is the pipe symbol, and the first built-in pipe which I'm going to make a use is uppercase. So what this uppercase will do, it is going to convert this name into an uppercase. I'm just copying this. Here I'm going to make a use of a br tag, and I'm just copying this statement, and within this I'm going to make a use of another inbuilt pipe that will be called as lower case. Now I'm going to save all this application and test this application, and if I execute it, you can see that the pipe has been written in an uppercase and in bottom it has returned in a lower case. So now we are going to understand some another inbuilt pipes as well. And for this, I'm going to make a use of my app.component.ts. Now within this, I'm going to make a use of date pipe. So what exactly I'm going to do is, here I have created a variable named as date, and within this, I'm going to create an instance of this date. In order to display dates in an Angular 4, you can make a use of this date class. And here I'm going to specify a date somewhat like this, 1993. Month, and I'm going to specify an year, let's say 15. Let's say day I have specified as a 15. Within this app.component.html file, I'm going to make a use of this br tag again. And here within my h2 tag, I'm going to display this day. So here I'm going to make a use of my string interpolation, and within this, I'm going to specify my day. So just save all this application, and we'll see the output. You can see that a date has been printed out in its default format. First of all, it has written us the day, then month, the day, and 1993. So this is the default format of date in Angular. So what exactly I'm going to do is, within this I'm going to make a use of pipe. Let's say here I'm just copying this statement, and within this I'm going to make a use of this pipe, and the built-in pipe which I'm going to make a use is called as date. So now I'm going to save all this application and see the desired output. Now you can see that a date has been returned out, month, day, and the year. One more point to be noted down here is I have specified the month as 3. If you see, let's say if this is a 3, then the month has to be returned out March. But you can see in our output it is showing us April, because in Angular 4 date format is start with your 0. Here 0 stands for your Jan, 1 stands for your Feb, and so on. That is why this third has been returned out as April. So now we are going to work with some other pipes as well. Within this date, you can make a use of some built-in pipes as well. Let's say I'm just copying the statement, and within this day, with the help of this pipe, now I'm going to specify a parameter. Let's say one parameter is short date. So let me just write it over here. D will be the caps. D will be in caps. Now save all this application and test our program. So now you can see that a date has been written in a short date format. This is the default format of your short date. In a same scenario, you can make a use of full date as well. So instead of this short, what exactly I'm going to do is I'm going to write over here full date. Save all this application and test and see the desired output. This is the difference between your full date. The day has been written, month, the day, and the year. So this is the concept of your date in Angular 4. One more formatting you can provide to your date. Let's say I want to print this date in a format of month, DD, and YY. Or let's say you can say that I have my predefined date. I want to print my date in my predefined format. So I'm going to copy this statement, and within this date, I'm going to specify my own defined date format. So here I'm going to make a use of M. Here I'm going to make a use of DD, and within this I'm going to make a use of YY. So let me just save all this application and we'll test to see the output. I'm going to scroll down. So now you can see, okay, sorry, one more point to be noted down here is, let's say we have to specify this M in a caps. This little M will indicate your minutes. So I'm going to make a use of this capital M. I'm going to save all this application. Now you can see that the month has been returned out. So this is the concept of your dates in Angular. Now we can use multiple pipes within same interpolation as well. We'll show you it with the help of an example. So here in our project app.component.html, I'm going to copy the statement, and within this full date, I can specify one more concept. Let's say here I'm going to make a use of this pipe, and I'm going to specify an uppercase pipe over here. So you can use multiple pipe within same interpolation, and that concept is called as your pipe chaining. So now I'm going to save all this application and we'll see our desired output. So you can see that the date has been returned to us in a upper case. So now the next step is we are going to create our own custom pipe. So what exactly for this demonstration we are going to do is, we are going to create a pipe that is going to sort an array. So within our app.component.ts file, here I'm going to declare an array, and the name of my array is ARR array. And within this, I'm going to specify certain variables. Let's say 3, 7, 8, 2, and 1. So let's say within this array, I have specified some elements. Now here we are going to create our custom pipe. In order to create a custom file, I'm going to make a use of this app, and within this app, I'm going to create a new TypeScript file. So I'm going to select this app, right click on it, and here I'm going to select this new file. Here I'm going to create a new file, and I'm going to name that file is app.sort.ts. Okay, so here I have created a new file named as app.sort.ts. Now within this file, our first step is we have to import a package for pipe. The package which we required in order to work with pipe is import pipe and I'm going to import another package as well, import pipe transform from @ angular core. So from here you can import a pipe from with this angular underscore angular forward slash core. Now the next step is to, we are going to make a use of pipe declarator over here. In order to declare a pipe, I'm going to make a use of this @ sign. We have to write pipe. So this will be called as our pipe decorator, and within this pipe decorator you have to specify the name of your pipe. So let's say I'm going to name my pipe as sort. This is going to be the name of my pipe. Okay, you don't need to put this semicolon over here. I'm going to remove this. Now within this I'm going to make a use of export class. This is a class which we will be implementing. Sort pipe is the name of my class, and it is going to implement pipe transform. So first of all, I would like to tell you what is this pipe transform is. The pipe class implements the pipe transform interface is called as transform. This transform method accepts the input value followed by optional parameter. It's upon you whether you can specify parameters or not. And what this method will do, this method will return you the transformed value. So within this, I'm going to make a use of a method known as transform. So this is the method which we are going to make a use, transform. So what this method will do, this method will take an argument from you and convert those argument into your desired output. So I'm going to create this method as a parameterized method, and it is going to receive the value, and the parameter of that value will be any, means it can be of any data type, either it can be a string or integer. And here I'm going to specify arguments as well, and the type of arguments will be the string. And you have to make a use of this colon, and after that you have to specify any curly braces. So here in this transform method we have specify a value which is going to be type of any, and the argument will be of type string, and the value which has been returned out is of type any. Okay, so you can pass a string into it, you can pass integer into this. So here I have specified the value which is going to be returned as any. Now within this I am going to make a use of if statement. If our arguments will be is equal to ascending, okay, if user is going to pass argument as an ascending, then I am going to return value, and here I am going to perform a sort. So what this sort method will do, it is an inbuilt method in your Angular. It is going to sort your array list in an ascending order. By default it is going to sort our array elements in an ascending order. Here I am going to make a use of else. If arguments is equal to descending, then I am going to return value, and here I am going to make a use of inbuilt method sort, and I am going to reverse this value. So our elements will get sorted in a descending order. Okay, so this is the declaration of our class called sort pipe. So here I am going to save all this application, and now we are going to make a use of this pipe. In order to make a use of this pipe, I'm going to make a use of this app.component.html, and here I'm just copying this statement, and within the string interpolation I'm going to specify my arr. This arr we have already declared in our app.component.ts, and the pipe which I'm going to use is sort. Okay, and the parameter which I'm giving to this pipe is ascending. So what this will do, it is going to sort our array list in an ascending order. Okay, one more thing we have to do is within our app.module.ts, we have to specify that we are going to make a use of a pipe. So here I'm going to import the name of our class is sort pipe. Here I'm going to specify the name of this class which we have specified in our app.sort.ts, sort pipe. So here I have imported this file from app.sort TypeScript file. And one more change we have to do is within the declaration, we have to specify that we are going to make a use of sort pipe. Okay. So now I'm going to save all this application. And let's just test this application. I'm going to scroll down. So now you can see that our list of an array has been returned out in an ascending order. Here you can see the changes as well. Let's say here I'm going to specify the parameter as descending. So in ascending, here I'm going to make a use of descending as well. So now I'm going to save all this application and we are going to test our application. Now you can see that an element has been returned in 87321. So this is the concept of creating our own custom pipe. Now I would like to tell you some more built-in pipes as well. So within this app.component.ts, here I'm going to declare a variable named as currency, CUR for short form, and I'm going to specify a value, let's say 98. Now within our app.component.html, I'm just copying this statement, and within the string interpolation, I'm going to change these values. Here you can make a use of inbuilt pipe called as currency. So what this currency will do, this will convert your 98 value in a format of a currency. So let me just first save this application and see the output. So the by default format is USD. What if you want to display this in a format of an INR? So what you can do is, here in this currency, you can specify colon and you can specify the type as INR. Okay, just save this application and see the desired output. Now you can see that the value has been returned in INR. So you can specify a parameter to this inbuilt pipe currency. One more pipe I would like to tell you is, let's say within this app.component.ts, I have declared a variable which is commonly used pipe, and I'm going to declare a value 12.764321, let's say 764321. Okay, so I have declared a variable num and I have specified a value 12.765431. Now within this I am going to make a use of a inbuilt pipe and the name of that pipe is number. So what this number will do, we'll show you. So here within the string interpolation I am going to make a use of num, and with this num I am going to make a use of number pipe. And I'm going to specify parameters somewhat like this, 3.2 - 5. Okay, it is little confusing, but I will explain you. So first of all, I'm going to save all this application and we'll see the output whether it is working or not. Okay, so now you can see that the value has been returned at 0.1276543. Okay, why this value has been returned out? This is the note over here. Okay, we have used a format of 3.2 - 5. So this 3 will indicate the minimum integer digit which will be displayed at the very beginning. So you can see that a 3 value has been returned out, 012, and after that you have used minimum fraction digit, that is 2 to 5, means after this decimal value you will going to have a value within a range of 2 to 5. So we can calculate it over here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, or let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this is the concept of our pipes in Angular.